Good evening. Tonight I want to speak on a subject that borders on fiction and definitely enters the realm of the supernatural. The subject I'd like to lecture on tonight is on incubus and succubus. Before we begin, let me pray. Father, I do pray and ask that you bless this teaching, that, Lord, it would be instrumental in helping others. In Christ's name I pray. Amen. Incubus and succubus are titles or names that have been given to entities or demonic spirits that afflict people most of the time during their dreams or at night. To be more specific, they're demons of sexual hatred and rage. And they fall into the guise and into the categories of the wraiths. There are 13 guilds of wraiths and wraith masters. And these fall into the category of a wraith, W-R-A-I-T-H. For instance, when Christopher Columbus was sailing to America, one of the shipmen on there had been ill-treated by an Irish person, and so they summoned wraiths in a ritual to send to the Irish coast to frighten and terrify the children. And they called them the Banshee, and demonic demons to bring fear, paranoia, and sometimes death. Incubus and succubus fall under that category. Now, they're a demonic spirit, but they come and they can take several forms. The first form that they'll take is that of a dream. I had an individual, I've worked with people from literally several countries to help them get rid of incubus or succubus that were afflicting their clients. Ireland, I've had a psychologist from Ireland referred to me. I helped teach them how to get rid of incubus, succubus. I had another one from Scotland. I've worked with German, East German people. And then all across this country. One time, it seemed like that's what I was doing almost every week, was getting contacted by somebody with a problem with a sexual demon of hatred or rage. The first form that they can take is that of the dream or the wisp. And what they'll do is when a person falls into a sleep state, they will enter into that person's sleep state as a dream, and they will then have sexual dreams. Those sexual dreams will have very strong feelings attached to them, so that if the person, and they often do, wakes up, they will find themselves climaxing. I've had individuals tell me that they were climaxing so hard that their legs and body was shaking, that they had never had such powerful orgasms, and it was a spirit. They couldn't see it, but they could feel it. I had another woman that contacted me after her husband had died. This spirit started entering the room, and it would manifest and look like him. It was a wisp of a ghost, and it tried to have sex, and she learned how to command it to leave, and it left. These entities will suck the energy and the life of an individual, and they will bring curses upon them through that. Oftentimes, witches, Satanists will use these entities and to curse individuals. And they will begin to curse by basically, you see, you can't curse somebody unless you have a reason. And if they fall into a sexual perverseness, in other words, they start having dirty dreams and having sex with entities, then that opens the doorway to be cursed. Now, the entity will take on the appearance of somebody that that individual trusts or is in love with. That's the first form, is where it will come in the form of a dream, and the person will dream they're having sex and they'll literally orgasm from it. The second is where the entity will actually solidify, to where they'll see a wisp, like the woman whose husband had died, and it began appearing like a wisp or as a ghost. And when they do that, they will be able to materialize in the room, speak, and they'll lie to the individual. They'll pretend to be that person, and that way that person will, that they're speaking to, will accept them, allow them to begin having relations with them. I had a person come to me who the entity would look like their husband, and at first they were dreaming about it, and then they started waking up and they would see it on top of them and it looked like their husband, but the sexual experience was so good that they didn't tell their husband. The husband would be gone for sometimes weeks at a time with his job. They contacted me when the entity started becoming violent and hurting her. So the second state is where they become like a ghost-like wisp. That takes us to the third state. The third state is where they will physically materialize. And when they physically materialize, they will do everything that they can. They have supernatural power, strength. They can create fear, intense pain, and they can literally hurt you. They can. I've had incubuses materialize and bite chunks out of people. And the fourth stage that they can appear is as a demon of death. It's where they will literally materialize and seek to kill the individual, choking them to death, suffocating them, stopping their heart. They're very evil. Now, how does a person get an incubus or succubus problem? They always come through a cursed object or a curse being put upon the person. I will start first with a curse upon a person. I worked with an individual, and that person was referred to me because their counselor didn't believe what they were telling them about how demons would materialize in the room and a person would be with them and be commanding the demons, and the demons would be having sex with her and forcing her to do things. Well, she was telling the truth. It was a Satanist, a high-level satanic priest, had targeted her, and she didn't know that he had made a link to her because he had abused her and used hypnosis, and while she was under hypnosis, he would use her sexually. He was a businessman, and she had gone to him basically for help in this specific profession that he was in. Well, he would materialize in her bedroom. Now, she hadn't seen him for some time. She never went back to his practice. But he began materializing in her room around midnight and would have two demons that would manifest, and they would have large male organs, and he would tell them what to do, and they would sexually abuse her. And sure enough, she called me, and I was on the phone with her when they materialized. And basically, I helped her to sever the ties to him and to reverse the curses and to command them to leave. And he was very angry. I could hear him speaking to me. He was very verbal. And they don't like it when you take their property. Satanists, once they target somebody, they don't like it if you take it away, because the rule in the satanic kingdom is the strong take from the weak. That's how a person can be cursed, is through an unholy soul tie or a link to somebody in the occult. If they get your DNA, they can target you. They can get your DNA through a cigarette butt, through a piece of food you've eaten off of, through handling something, through a piece of clothing, through hair. And they can do a ritual where they can send a succubus or an incubus to your home to terrorize you or your children. I had a CEO from a large nationwide company contact me. Their child was screaming, their 14-year-old son was screaming. She went to go there and she opens the door and sees this demon on top of it. And it's raping it. And he's screaming it. She said she went to try to grab it, and she was flung backwards out of the door, and the door slammed, and she could not get the door open. And all she could do was hear him scream. So, basically, I prayed and asked the Lord to reveal to her why it had the authority to attack her son. Keynote, rule number one. An incubus or succubus has to have authority to afflict a person or their family. That's why a Satanist or a witch will curse you through your personal possessions. Because that'll give them the authority to enter into your home. If it's your hair, the demon can take that DNA from that hair and go right back to the person whose it was. Well, this individual was a Christian, and they got a position as a CEO, and unfortunately, there was a high-level satanic priestess that also was vying for that position. And she had cursed this Christian woman. And as a result, this incubus came back with her with the curse and began assaulting her children at night. And she was powerless to do anything about it. She was a single mother and nobody would help her. We prayed and it manifested while I was praying. I told her to remain calm. I commanded it. I had no authority to command it, it said, so I asked the Lord to have angels manifest to hold it. They did. Rule number two, if it has authority to be there, you cannot command it. It has the right, and it's a powerful demon. It's a prince. So you have to pray and ask God to send angels, holy angels, elect angels from his throne room to hold it. I did. It was held there. She said, it's not moving. And I said, now, Heavenly Father, would you reveal to her why? And she says, this woman... I hear this woman's name in my head. I said, Lord, would you speak to her and tell her why she's hearing that name? She says she's cursed me. And I always pray and ask the Lord to reveal to the person. The Lord spoke to her because a sheep will always hear his voice. The Holy Spirit speaks to us and will reveal why the curse came. So we prayed. She asked the Lord to cleanse her from the curse and to sever all unholy ties and attachments and to send the spirit away. It left. She's not having problems since. So the first way that an incubus or succubus can come is by a person being cursed by a Satanist, a witch, a cultist, a voodoo priest, someone like that. The second way an incubus or succubus can attach to a person is through an unholy form of worship. I had a Christian young man who was a youth minister who had been through some very high-named colleges. He was in a very well-to-do position who began getting sexually assaulted at night. At first, he enjoyed it, but then it became uncontrollable. It was taking all his energy, his time, controlling his mind. He contacted me. So over the phone, I worked with him. I prayed and I asked the Lord. I said, Lord, show him why it's got authority. As soon as I prayed, it manifested in the room with him. He was scared. I told him not to be. I asked the Lord to hold it, have angels go there to hold it from his throne room. It was held. I apologize. I'm very tired tonight, folks. I work another full-time job. So if I'm slurring, it's because I'm very tired. So I asked the Lord to have holy angels sent from his throne room to hold it. It was held. So I asked the Lord to reveal to him, and he said, well, I see in my mind me at a Tibetan monastery. I said, really, have you ever been to one? He says, yeah, I went there last year, took the youth on a mission trip. Interesting. I said, Lord, reveal to him why. He says, well, I don't know why. He says, I'm taking my shoes off at the bottom of the shrine, I'm putting bread on it, and now I'm ascending up and I'm spinning the bell and chiming the bells. And he says, I go in, I'm getting pictures taken with the monks, I'm kneeling before their shrines. I said, well, you took part in an unholy worship to Taoist gods. And there's some very evil sexual demons attached to these Taoist monks. They take on these vows of celibacy, but actually they're burning with rage and lust. I said, when you took your shoes off at the base, which is before you go up the stairs, that is your way of agreeing that that was holy ground. Then when you took and kneeled before the shrine and put bread upon it, you were making an offering to an unholy god. When you ascended the stairs, you went up to the high place to worship. When you spun the bell, because they would spin these bells or wooden pole things, I said you were summoning the spirit. And then when you rang the bell, the spirit was there. Then you kneeled in front of the shrine and took part with the monks. I said you worshipped it and it came into you. That's what happened. I led him in prayer to ask God to forgive him for his ignorance, for worshiping a false deity, confessing his sin of enjoying the sex, and the demon left and has never been back. The third way that an incubus succubus can manifest into somebody is basically through invitation by fantasizing. If a person begins having filthy dreams, an incubus will attach to those dreams and will take the place of the person they're fantasizing about. It will take the place of those dreams, and over time, if the person gives in to them without confessing their sins or seeking to be cleansed, the incubus will gain an attachment and will have sex with them. The only way they can get rid of it is by confessing their sin of fantasizing, sexual immorality, demonic adultery, and asking God to cleanse them, sever all unholy ties and attachments, and to cast or to send the spirit where he commands it to go by the voice of his Holy Spirit. Those are the easy ones to get rid of. Now, the fourth way that you can get an incubus or a succubus, and this is the worst ones to deal with, is through a cursed object. I had a family, lived in the town next to the town I was in where I was pastoring, and they were of another denomination of faith. They were Lutheran, and I was a Baptist. And they called me out, the man's sitting in the room, the woman's there, and they're looking at each other. I said, well, why am I here? And he's shaking his head. He says, he's not going to believe us. I said, tell me what it is. And she says, well, something has physically attacked me in the night. It drugged me, spread my legs, and began raping me to the point where I was bleeding. And it tore my insides, and it's happened several nights in a row now. We don't know why. He can't get in. It waits until he's in another room, and the door slams, and he can't get the door open. He's even shot the handle with his 44 Magnum. He can't get the door open. And it was just very terrible. So I asked them if I could have permission or authority to pray. They said yes. And as soon as I did, it manifested. It appeared right there. And I asked the Lord to hold it. And I said, Lord, would you speak to them? Why is it here? And she says, well, I see a lamp. I said, what do you mean you see a lamp? She says, I see a lamp that we bought at a garage sale last week. I said, where's it at? She says, it's in the garage. I said, Lord, why does she see that lamp? She says, it's cursed, he says. So we go out and look at it. It looks like a normal lamp, an antique. It's a really nice one. So we prayed, asked God to reverse the curse, to take it off there, to cleanse it, make it holy, dedicate it unto the Lord God, and thanked him for being able to use it. Asked him to send the entity away. It left, never returned again. Theirs was from a cursed object that was brought into their home. Now, an unholy soul tie or attachment. Fifth way. I had a couple referred to me by a psychiatrist. And he said, this is way out of left field. He says, I'm going to tell you, it's real. He said, she came to me telling me she's being molested in bed. Her husband didn't believe her, because it happens when he's not home. He's away at work. He says, I went to the house with them, and something materialized in the room. I don't know what it is. He said, I'm not even going to, if you tell anybody, he says, I won't admit it, but it was there. He says, so I told them they needed a clergy. I called around. Everybody says that you're the man. So I go to their home, and we sit down, and I asked them, and she basically told me the same story, that something started molesting her at night. It would force her, hold her down, spread her legs, and was raping her. And the first time it came in and sat down on the bed, she thought it was her husband. She turned, nobody's there, but the bed is sunk down under the weight. And the strange thing is, the smell of perfumed flowers would always be in the room. So we prayed, and as soon as I prayed, the room filled with the smell of flowers. It was there. I couldn't see it, but I could feel its presence. I asked the Lord to hold it and to reveal while it was there. She said she saw the palm reader she went to at the fair. And then she began seeing the woman. She had only gone a couple times. And basically she was cursed by a witch or an occultist. So we pray and ask God to forgive her for it, to cleanse her home, and take the curse off her and command it to leave. I went to visit that poem reader. And I'm going to tell you what, when I walked in there, the feeling in there, that place was filled with evil. She's a very powerful witch. And she did not like me. When I walked in, she stared at me and she goes, "You're not welcome in this place. Leave now." I said, "Okay." And I left. That's the fifth way. Now, cursed objects. If a person goes to a voodoo priest or a hoodoo priest, a cursed object can bring a demon of rage and hatred and sexual violence. Do not yoke yourself to unclean things. The way you get rid of an incubus or succubus is you find out what authority it has. You ask God to remove that authority, to cleanse you from it, to forgive you for any sins involved, and then for God to sever all unholy soul ties and attachments, and to cleanse your home, to cleanse the object, to sanctify them according to His Word and with His holy power and His Holy Spirit, and to send that spirit away. I had a couple come to me. The woman was being sexually assaulted. It appeared while the man was there. It threw him down, bit a chunk out of his chest, big mouth print. It was vicious. And then raped her in front of him. And when I asked for authority to pray, it manifested right in front of me. But first, her chair lifted in the air, and I could see it. She couldn't move. She was pinned. He ran through the house into my son's room. This is at my home. And I could see the impression of something striking her. Her whole face caving in, but her body couldn't move because something was holding there while it was hitting her. And I said, "I command you to be bound." Her chair is hovering in the air, by the way. Her chair went back down, and then right in front of me on the table, it was like this tall. It was red, humanoid dragon-like, with a tail, scale, and fiery yellow eyes. It was red and black. And it's staring at me. And I said, "You can't hurt me. I have a shield of faith." And it said, "You have no faith." I said, "You're right. I'm scared." This is the first time I'd seen an incubus. Now they don't bother me. I raised my hand. I said, "Father, forgive me for being afraid." I said, "Would you take and place your holy armor upon me and sell holy angels to hold this thing in its place?" And I looked at it and I said, "Now do I have a shield of faith on?" He says, "Yes." And it's speaking to me. And there's four other people in the room. I said, "Why didn't you hit me?" It said, "I did not have permission." It's very important to understand they cannot do anything unless they have authority, permission. You must keep yourself clean from spiritual, evil spiritual things. Things of the darkness, things of the occult. Incubus, succubus, incubi, succubi are real. They attach themselves to your DNA. They're sexual demons of lust. If they get a stronghold in you, they will cause you to lust all the time. They will work through your fantasies. They will make dreams with your children. They're a nasty, evil, violent, foul demon from hell. I hope this lecture has been helpful to you. May the Lord bless you in your endeavors to serve. P.S. If you need help getting rid of one, you can contact me. My phone number is on my website. My book, Contending for the Faith, describes how to get rid of them. And in my little book of prayers, there's a prayer for getting rid of them. Okay, Lord bless you.